Yeah. Self-reliance is the opposite of tawakkul. What do we believe in? Tawakkul. Tawakkul means to rely on Allah. It literally means to place Allah as the person who is in charge of your affairs. Allah is your wakil. What's the Arabic word wakil? What does it mean? The person who is in charge of your affairs. It's also the word for lawyer, right? So I'm a wakil, yeah? But when you say this to Allah, it's Allah, one of Allah's attributes, he's al-wakil, means he is in charge of all of our affairs. When you let go of that self-reliance, then you practice ultimate tawheed. Yeah? Your internal spiritual attitude that only Allah counts, nothing I do counts. Now I'd like to tell you a short story about a friend of mine who was memorizing Qur'an. So he was memorizing about 3 pages a day, and it would take him about half an hour to memorize each page. And what he would do is sit down, and in 1.5 hours he'd memorize 3 pages. One day he was really busy outside, he came home at 11 p.m, hungry and tired. And he sat down at the table, and he realized that he does not have the energy or the ability to do this on this occasion, so he made a dua. And he said, "Oh Allah, I know that this is hard for me, but I also know that this is easy for you, so do this for me." And he sat down and he started memorizing. When he finished his 3 pages, he looked up at the clock and it had only been 30 minutes. In 30 minutes on this day, he memorized 1.5 pages, which demonstrates that when we rely upon Allah, we rely upon Allah's infinite qudra, his infinite power, and his infinite mercy. And we go beyond ourselves, we go away from self-reliance. And when we do that, then our ability to achieve things taps into that infinity of Allah. It's amazing. And Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى أَرْرَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى. The human being goes astray when he considers himself to be self-reliant. Al-istighna means self-reliance. So when we place reliance upon ourselves, we go astray. So there's two things. Yeah? We need to say, internally, we need to have a spiritual, psychological attitude, an internal attitude, which is that nothing I do matters. Nothing I do matters. But we need to act on the outside. Our actions have to demonstrate that everything I do matters. So an external action is everything I do matters. I call this the internal perspective and the external perspective. What do you think perspective means? I made that word up myself. It's a neologism. Yeah? Hikmah Salmaniya. Salmanic wisdom. But what does perspective mean? What do you think? Yeah, to work until you sweat. Yeah, so you work until you sweat, as though everything you do matters. But internally, your internal perspective is that nothing you do matters, because you've relied on Allah. And if you do that, you will never suffer depression, you'll never suffer anxiety, you'll never suffer fear. Yeah, Allah says in the Quran, أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. The friends of Allah, they have no fear, and nor do they grieve. What is fear? Fear is if you live in the future, you fear the things that will happen. Grief is if you live in the past, you grieve for the loss that you suffered in the past. But the friends of Allah, they live neither in the future nor in the past. Where do they live? In the present, in the moment. They are Ibn al-Waqt, the son of the moment. Because it's this moment that I'm worshipping Allah now. The past is gone. The future hasn't come. It's this moment for which I'm responsible to Allah. And it's in this moment that I demonstrate my friendship to Allah. And if I do that, I will live neither in the future nor in the past. And I'll have no grief and no fear. Jazakumullah khair.